We're about to go climbing.
Yeah, what are we about? What are we going to be doing?
So, 10-15 minutes time, James. We will be high in the sky, climbing trees, and ziplining across a lake.
That sounds fun.
Mm.
Are you excited for that?
I am. Are you?
No.
There we go. I'm just working on new stuff now, working on a lot of different things compared to what I was doing back at home. I enjoy doing sound. I'm not the best at it. I'm getting the hang of it. It's taking a while, but that's what I'm focusing in at the moment. But that doesn't mean I don't want to direct. Like, I really enjoy directing, and I still want to do all my projects that I've planned for years.
This is my room this year, which you haven't really seen. The other side of the camera is just my bed. It's a tip, so it doesn't really matter. But this is my room. I've got all my stuff up here and things. It's quite nice. A lot has happened since I last made an episode. The coronavirus is getting increasingly worse. But we've all sort of been, you know, this episode has taken place before the second lockdown and the third lockdown. Quite a lot of moments have for this one. The first segment, which you saw, was when we went to Centre Parcs. We did the same last year, so we did the same for 2020. And it was good fun. We had a nice time. We were there for a week, and we were sort of just relaxing, chilling, and doing the usual stuff. I filmed that whole segment with the DJI Osmo Pocket, to test the waters with it a bit more again, see what kind of shots it could do. I was very happy with the shot, like the panning, turning shot that you saw. That was a lot of fun. My audio equipment, since Christmas happened, is also updated. I used to use this, the Zoom H1. I've been using that for a fair few years now. And I've just changed to the Zoom H6, which was a mic we used in our first year of uni. But we still rent from time to time and we do projects. And that was mainly because I felt I needed to upgrade. I'm focusing on sound quite a lot and I wanted a better recording device than the current one. I've got this one. For those who are interested, it only can record via the mic or a 3.5mm jack lead, which is doable, but it wouldn't sound great. Whereas this thing has its built-in mics on the top and XLR, four XLR ports, which is great. It can be used for like podcasting music, same as what the Zoom H1 could be used for, just sort of you can have four people at once working on it. So for music, if I wanted to record a piano and my vocals at the same time, I could, which makes it a very interesting device, and I'm very glad I have it, and I'm looking forward to using it more in projects. It's a lot larger than the old one. For university, I've just wrapped on a project called Clamped, which was a short film I worked on. I had a lot of fun doing that. I had a lot of fun doing the sound design for it and messing around with it. We've just submitted that to our tutors and we just watched it as a collective via Zoom. It was good fun. I had a challenge with sound. There were lots of places where there were no sound and I created a soundscape myself, which I'm very proud of. And I'm hoping that maybe the tutors recognise that. I don't know if they will or not. But yeah, that was a good project. I believe the next stage for that is film festivals. It'll be interesting to see if anything happens there. But apart from that, there's, you know, not much for me to say. That the reason there hasn't been an episode is because that's been primarily my main focus for the past few months. It's been very stressful, but I'm glad it's done and I'm glad how it came out. It's great. I don't know if that's ever going to get publicly released or it's just going to be film festivals, I can't tell you.
I'm just going to walk through
the next segment we are going into is when Pat and I went to Broadway Tower. This was a fun little adventure we had. Pat is very into the Dark Tower stories by Stephen King and I decided to take him out for the day because we were both a bit bored and we went to check it out. So I'll take you on into that segment.
I hope you know this footage is going to come out shaky as fuck.
This time I'm actually using the Zoom, which is interesting. I need to get a sort of head for this zoom and it's be quite like how this one is. So this one's got like a pop mic, and when I say my P's, it did it right then. So I can't, like, I've got a P, got to say it backwards a bit, which is really annoying. I'm gonna see if I can balance it down somewhere. Cassette player, don't fail me now. But I also got the opportunity to work on a BBC New Creatives project. It's a film called These Lines That Divide Us, and it's a documentary about the English flag. I got asked if I wanted to do sound recording for it, since I think I was the only person that the crew sort of knew who owned a Zoom and microphones. So I agreed to. I was very eager to. It's great for my portfolio, and it turned out it was really fun. I really enjoyed it. I only did 3 days. Everything was filmed at a slow frame rate, so the sound was more as an ambient track. So I was going out of my way to make noises around. We were at a football stadium on the first day, and I was going out of my way to make sounds. That eventually will be put on BBC iPlayer, from what I can tell, but this was the fourth round of new creative projects, and I believe the second and third rounds haven't been uploaded to BBC iPlayer yet, or the third rounds haven't been, so it will be like a long time. I think it will be like end of this year, maybe start of next year, but when it does get uploaded to BBC iPlayer, I'll be talking about it straight away, because I'd like you all to see it, and not just because I've worked on it, because I think it's a very interesting project. I enjoyed doing it. When I was asked to do it, I had a little look into it, what it was about, and I thought it was interesting, and it was good fun. It was a proper film set as well. It wasn't like a uni project. We sort of, you know, we had to be tight on stuff and, you know, down to the T, and that was good experience for me, and I really enjoyed it. And I hope to Will and Cameron that the project goes well in further development. I look forward to finally seeing it out. It's nice to say that you've contributed to something like that. I've recently also been getting into Photoshop and my editing skills there, and I've had a lot of fun. Some of those are appearing. Let's have a little look into some of these. This was the first one I did, and it was one of myself, and I'm actually wearing the same hoodie. And this was one I did of Morgan. So what you see here is that's Bath down here. That's Bath's, the Bath spars. And I added some text from an email, and a little alien thing here, and this is all Bath Spa with a gate-like placed in front. That's a shaver up there. And there was when Morgan and I were walking back one night, we found this, what you'd find adverts placed in. There was a, it was missing, it had been smashed. And so the white strips were all that remained. And so I took a picture in front of it, of Morgan with it, and the photo didn't look very good. Not as well as I wanted to turn out, and I'd only taken it on my phone. So I added 4 different layers on top of Morgan here. And what you can see are he's got like blue, purple are like the primary things, but underneath there's like a bit of red here and green down here. And these are actually underneath him, but they're all at different opacities. So the ones that the purple and the blues are on top, but there are reds and greens in places. And that's because the opacity on the reds and the purples and the blues aren't as strong, so they come through again. I started to get back into a bit of drawing, and so I created this one. This is a film called It's Such a Beautiful Day, and I drew the main character into Pitfield Park in Cheltenham, and I sort of did that on top of a real image. They sort of look a bit, you're a bit uncomfortable by the design, and that's purposeful. I wanted to do that's how I like to draw faces. I like to make them just look a bit weird. The next segment we're about to go into is when I went to Bath back in December. I've been to Bath before, but I'd never been to the Roman Bath Spas. We went, and it was really interesting. And at the time, I'd recently just watched a film by Andrei Tarkovsky called Nostalgia. And I have a real appreciation for this film. It's recently became a favourite of mine. Definitely in my top 5 films I've seen. The imagery in this film is absolutely incredible. So after seeing the Bath Spas, I decided to make an edit mixed in with footage from Nostalgia
to sort of create this funky kind of, from one of the scenes in the film, this funky transition of modern footage to the old film footage. And yeah, it was a good bit of inspiration that I hadn't had for some time, and sort of encouraged me to keep working and really start this episode. So yeah, hope you enjoy that. Right, okay, we now come to the part where I talk about the bit you probably don't want to hear about, my music. So the songs you've already heard that are currently on my Spotify are not produced by me. They are me playing on piano and me singing, and written by me, obviously, but not produced. And I'm trying to get into producing. I have decided to cancel, for the meantime, my Isolation album. And this is mainly because the album is very depressing. And I want to try and produce myself. I want to make a different style of music rather than the pop aspect that I've been doing before. I want to go a bit more hip-hop, R&B, and soul. She's got no life. Because those are the music genres I listen to. There are like two tracks from the album that still haven't been uploaded, and I will come back to that album. So I wanted to make more upbeat stuff. So this is a track called Long Way that I've been working on. and I'll sort of give you a little insight. We've got stuff like this. I need to figure out EQ and all that for the vocals. The vocals are very demo. But this is a track we're working on, and we're currently working on a whole mixtape. I'm working on this with a guy called Martin Young. The budget for Isolation, the album, was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 tracks out of 14 were done, and each track cost £200 to produce. And it wasn't cheap. And this will be sort of a thing I'll come to over time, because I want to do this with Max, the producer I had for this album. I don't want to do it with anyone else. I like the style that he did for this album. But it's not possible to release at the moment. And rather, I need to keep producing my own stuff. There will be more releases for this album after the mixtape. Golden Girl is a track here. That was the first song I wrote when I was 18, and I love it. It's one of my favorite tracks I've ever done, and I look forward to hearing that one. And that one is complete, and that features my friend Finn on guitar. Do I see a future career in music? No. This is for fun. There's no business side to this. This is just me making tunes, and the more people that enjoy them, the better. I'd love to make music my profession, but I don't see that happening anytime soon. Is today?
It's March the 1st?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Do it every year.
Oh wait, is it like the 3 year or 5 year anniversary or something like that?
It's the 4 year.
4 year. Is it the 4th year anniversary of what I'm thinking about?
Yeah. Today is the 1st of March, and I don't really know what the point of this video is.
Today is the 1st of March.
Today is the 1st of March.
Today is the 1st of March.
Today is the 1st of March. Which means I've been doing this for 4 years. I'll keep it short and simple. I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who watches. If you watched all of this episode, thank you very much, and thank you for watching the previous ones. I hope to release more of these this year. Trying a new style with this one, talking more about my work in between segments rather than just jibber jabbing about anything. This year has been a big strain on all of us, and I hope everyone is keeping safe and doing well. If you are feeling rough, talk to someone, talk to a friend. You know, everyone's going through the same thing. Everyone's going to want to help each other. And if they don't, they're probably not a very good friend. I look forward to the future. I look forward to doing more. There's a lot of promising things on the way for me. And it's going to be very exciting to see the outcome of the next year and what I'm doing and what I'm thinking about. Thank you all very much for watching. I hope you have a good day.